Hello everyone, welcome back to our new session of the Excel. So here in this session I will explain you how to use the date function in Excel. So just like when we are working with the date and time, so that time it's mandate to use that function so that we will minimize our effort or save our time in formatting. So these functions are very useful at the time of when we are working with the large number of data which contains millions of records. Just like if we are considering example of any subject information of any classes or college, so that time when we want to calculate any specific date range or duration of that, it is very helpful to calculate that. If that function is not available, definitely we lose our effort and time for formatting or creating the report. So for complete understanding, please be available from start to end of this tutorial so that you learn how we can format our date and time or manage our stuffs in an easiest way, so that whenever we are working on the large number of data which is more than 10,000, 15,000, that time this will plays a very important role. So date function will contains date, month and year, but in Excel the date is always present in YYYMMDD, that is year, month and date, but it's possible to format that. By default the value is that, but it's possible to format the date will appear same format in the next time, so that will save automatically. So let's start with this. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for the updates. So you can see here I've already created one Excel here, the serial number, subject, start date, end date and duration. So for creating, if you don't have any idea about that, please watch my previous session so that you are able to create how you can add the data and formatting this stuff. So let's begin with, if I want to display any specific date or date which is present here, if I want to add or show the date in this format, when the date is available, just like I am here, year, month and this is date. So just like take an example of year is 2020, month is here 05 and date is 23. If I want to, there is already anything formula is present because of that is showing. So if I want to present, because I have written here the date, it's automatically to, just like if I am not writing anything, just writing 23, the format is set because of that it's showing. Let me copy and paste it to somewhere else, only this date, and I am writing here the 23, because here we have written date, all the columns are formatted on that specific item. If I want to create this type of data, then I just need to enter equal to then date, this comma month comma date, you can see formatted. Now you can also create it in date and time format based on the serial number. By this way you are able to format your data when data is year, month and date is present in three different columns. So that is the easiest way we can do it with date. just like here, if I want to show the duration of this, these two, just like I can see four subjects are there. If one subject is starting from 2nd of Jan 2019 and completing at 5th of June 2019, how much days it will took to complete from one subject to other? So if I want to calculate that, simply I will use equal to, then days. You can see here different functions are available, days 360. Once you will click that, just have to provide the column name. Once you will press enter, able to see here you are able to see the format, or in the, because it's present in this column and its cell is already converted to date and time format, because that it's not showing the actual value. But when you will use this data here, just like I am entering again here, so if you want to convert it to number, then enter this again, days 360, this one, and because it's 90, we have selected this one, so just use D2, means this column, rather than taking here. Now you can see 153 days are the numbers. So if you want to calculate the duration, if you want to calculate the complete table duration, just drag and drop this, and because here the month is present in 15, it's not in proper format. So once you'll clear this, you're able to see this, and again this one as well. Now you can see all the dates are formatted. If you want to convert this date into numbers, so that is also will be same for you. So let me convert it here. Now you can see same data, because this column is already formatted with the date format, because of that it was not showing in the numbers. So by this way you are able to calculate the duration. If you want to enter only the month of any specific date, you can also use that. Just enter the month, and select any column, you are able to see only month is written. In some time, sometime it's always required to collect the data from that. So by this way you can calculate the specific month of any column or any numbers. Now again, if you want to display specifically the today's date and time or the system date and time, just have to write now and close this. You're able to see complete timestamp. Date and time both are available in this cell. So this is a small function which will help us to minimize our effort and wrap up our work. So based on our requirements, just like if I'm removing the, if I want to calculate equal to minutes from this cell, let me try this. Able to see 36 is written, out of which 36. So 36 is the minute. So by this way you are able to calculate the minutes of any cell. Just like, let's try this well as well. Or if you want to calculate hour from this, you are able to see hour is also calculated. If I want to calculate or print the year of any specific date, I just have to write it here, year, and this function, you're able to see 2020 is printed here. So by this way, this all are date in time execution format, which will definitely help us to format the data in Excel. So this is all about the date and time function which is used in Excel. So you just have to write here the equal to symbol, and after equal to symbol you just need to mention the specific requirement, just like minute. So min is a minimum function, just have to write the minute, and you have to select the specific cell, you are able to see the particular data. So this is everything is applicable for month, date, year, time and hours. By this way you are able to calculate your detail. Hope you understand it. If you have any queries or comment, please comment in the comment section. And if you know that any specific additional function is available in date and time, please comment in the comment box so that others can also get help with that, because it is specifically learning and sharing data. So whenever you are sharing the content, definitely your knowledge will be improved. Now we'll come back in next session. Thank you for watching.